DNA origami are nanostructures inspired by the Japanese art of folding paper. They are built using a long single-stranded DNA that is given its specific shape and held together by short oligonucleotides, the staples, resulting in a double-stranded final structure. Depending on what you want to do, you can program the DNA origami to take any shape by using appropriate complementary oligonucleotides. You can load them with imaging and therapeutic agents, or even a combination of both. Let's take an example. You want to kill cancer cells, so you load the DNA origami with doxorubicin. Dox is an anti-neoplastic chemotherapy drug that intercalates in the double-stranded DNA of the nanostructure. You introduce these structures in the organism through injection. They travel through the bloodstream and exit in tumor sites where the vasculature is non-cohesive, thus making it leaky. They accumulate there because of the enhanced permeability and retention effect, also known as EPR. The DNA origami enters the cell through endocytosis, and there it starts releasing doxorubicin little by little. The drug is now free to act. It intercalates in the DNA, interferes with replication machinery and regulation pathways, causing the cell to die. What is great with this approach is that dox is not only delivered to the tumor sites, but by being trapped in the origami structure, it can escape the cell through the membrane efflux pumps that are usually highly expressed on tumor cells. This results in lower systemic toxicity as minimal quantities of dox escape. Another great advantage is that the drug is released gradually, so it acts over the course of a few hours and days, resulting in better outcomes for the patient. These origami structures are made from DNA, which is native in the biological environment, so when they are eventually degraded from enzymes like DNases, they don't seem to cause any problems. Overall, DNA origami is a very promising platform for delivery to the tumor and is expected to be used for a plethora of applications.